Hey everybody, this is David at Barnyard Bees. This is what a goldenrod flow looks like. Look at the bees, how active and flighty they are compared to where they was in August. Whenever you see this in your hives, you know with all that flight that they're working, bringing in lots of pollen, nectar. This is probably one of the best flows we've had for goldenrod. It is, I kind of excuse a mess. I got to pick up a little bit more. I was piddling around down here. But these bees are bringing in lots and lots of pollen and nectar. And like I said, you can't always depend on this goldenrod flow, but when it's good, it's good. And that can bring in lots and lots of stuff. So just remember that from year to year, because the conditions has to fall just right for it to be really good. If you have a real dry spell prior to the goldenrod, then a lot of goldenrod, it's not gonna come up, and if it does, it's not gonna be very productive. But if you get too much rain, then it kind of almost the same effect, but not as bad as the dry spells. We've had adequate amounts of rain through August and into September. So it's been a really, really productive goldenrod year. But I just thought I'd show you that, how, you know, now prior to this, I was feeding the bees with open feeders, and they was taking it down pretty hard and heavy. But once the flow started, they started slowing down with the sugar water, and they just almost completely stopped. And then, of course, you see this much. This is like spring over again. But of course, you know, your goldenrod flow is not near as productive as your spring flows, but it still can be pretty good. So just thought I'd show you that. Thanks for watching, Barnyard Bees.